Okay, and let's talk about the failure to rehabilitate Marawi City. This could be actually, it could serve as a catalyst it's either good economics prevents terrorism or bad economics actually can spawn, like, right? A terrorism in small numbers. But let's start with this. Marawi City, I went there. There are big buildings, auditoriums, tracks, a market. They're building a school. There's a big mall in Marawi City. Well, when I went there last year, all empty. All the residents were living in temporary shelters. They have not gone back to their homes. They cannot afford to rebuild their homes. All their homes are riddled with bullets. They're living in places where water is so expensive. They live in mga cargos, alam mo yon, yung container vans.
Container vans, yeah.
Iba. I mean, frankly speaking, it's been what, 4 or 5 years?
6 years, Karen.
6 years. Why aren't the residents back in Marawi City with rehabilitated homes? Lahat ng na-rehabilitate, puro building. Building na walang tao.
It's a good thing you mentioned.
Can't this breed terrorism?
That kind of frustration,
that kind of feeling of neglect na pabayaan anim na taon na.
In fact, Karen, by delaying the Marawi rehabilitation, it actually paves a fertile ground for violent extremism to grow. That's why our position really is to prioritize Marawi rehabilitation because it is well connected with our national security concern.
Pero ba't nauna yung mga building when I was there? Nauna yung mga malalaking auditorium, hindi nauna yung mga bahay ng mga tao.
That's, you know, your guess is as good as mine. I also want to know exactly how come the basic services have not been established first. Meaning, yesterday, it's a good thing that you mentioned the Marawi rehabilitation because yesterday we just had the second hearing. And unfortunately, I was so disappointed because I learned that LUWA hasn't really finished the putting up of facility. It involves several concerns, even legal issues, ownership of the land, etc. And the administrators changing of the administration of LUWA having new and bago na naman na administrator. So it also speaks about bureaucratic delays, no? It causes bureaucratic delays in the releasing of papers, downloading of funds. You know this, no? This is the actual bureaucratic processes. I'm so disappointed, no, Karen. So I share your disappointment, really. But right now, the message that we are sending across with what happened in MSU, it may be redirect again and readjusted the attention of the national government. So to focus on, hey, marami pa lang, ano, may rehabilitation, tas may bomba na naman dito. Baka makarecruit pa sila, it would be a fertile ground. Sabi ko nga, the more that we delay the rehabilitation, the more we are actually making the ground fertile for extremists to grow. Kasi ginagamit nila yan. And so, Karen, I guess, I'm happy that the leadership of the House, Speaker Martin Romualdez, actually the first one to create an ad hoc committee on Marawi rehabilitation. Imagine that when I assume office, I ask him, sir, we need to focus on Marawi rehabilitation.
Yeah.
And he said, yes, right away.
It's not about buildings. The irony during former President Duterte's time, billions and billions were spent for rehabilitation, and they rehabilitated literally buildings. They did not rehabilitate people's lives. Rehabilitation is about people's lives.
Exactly. And I've been telling this to people, no, every time I get the chance to speak about Marawi rehabilitation, the very essence of rehabilitation is to bring the people back, returning to their community. That is exactly what the rehabilitation means. It's not only aesthetic, although it is important also and crucial in the rehabilitation process to rebuild the homes and rebuild the structures. It's very important. We cannot just simply set that aside. But primarily, the objective of that is to bring back the people to their communities where they used to live. Now that I think MSU, what happened in MSU is an eye opener again. Na, uy, kapala, no? Meron pa palang alang-aning na taon na hindi pala natatapos at hindi pa nakakabalik yung mga tao dyan. Remember, Karen, the reason why I said earlier that MSU has now become a host for so many people, businesses, not only students, businesses, because they no longer have anywhere to go except to go to MSU and then do business there. So the security is compromised. We're talking about 1,000 hectares, with so many students, with so many private individuals doing, whatever they're doing inside the campus without having to monitor, no, kung ano yung ginagawa nila. So that, this is one way of saying and, you know, sending the message across that we have to finally put an end to the rehabilitation talk. And sabi ko nga,
because, Representative, how sure are our authorities that the perpetrators aren't connected to the residents, right? Disgruntled residents of Marawi. There's no certainty. You know, the guess that it's connected to ISIL, ISIS, they're foreign terrorists. Frankly speaking, how sure are authorities that there's no connection whatsoever to disgruntled residents there?
Because if you're
living in those container vans, right?
Well, if people, group of people, loses the chance, the opportunity to make their lives a little bit better, because there's no opportunity, there's no the presence of an opportunity, no, readily available to them, some people might get into trouble later on. Yun ang sinasabi ko eh. That's why when we had the committee hearing yesterday, I asked them how long or how fast can you tell this committee now we will finally be able to see these facing, you know, yung eventual reintegration of the communities and the putting up of facilities, everything, the water and electricity. Sabi nila urgent. Sabi ko, don't give me generic terms because we've been waiting for 6 years. I want a specific date. And sinabi nila 2 weeks, so I hold them to their words. I'll ask again. Yeah,
well, the speaker, it would make such a difference if Speaker Martin Romualdez, along with yourself, if you can take him to Marawi today. I think it's important for the president, the speaker, to see Marawi today, to see where the people live.
Yeah. Well, the president has visited the place, no? Pero nagka-COVID nga daw siya, eh, di ba? I heard yesterday.
Where the people live. Where the people live.
Okay. Not necessarily connected with MSU bombing. Yes, I agree with you. In fact, next year, January, I'm planning to hold a public hearing in Marawi. I know that we've been doing this a lot, series of public consultation and public, but I think it is necessary. No, not to lose hope in the process, because that's the only way we can actually get support from the national government to use all the platforms, all the available mechanism tools that we at our disposal to attract further the attention of data. Yeah, I agree with you. Created the ad hoc committee. So nakita natin yung sincerity niya at saka yung commitment niya to finally see Marawi rehabilitated. And yes, by January, I'm going to talk this over with the speaker again, because there's really a plan, no, on visiting Marawi with the speaker.
Okay. And I wanted to ask you, what is the hindrance? For example, if you were a former resident of Marawi, because for those who haven't been to Marawi recently, the homes of the residents are all riddled with bullets. And what happens is the residents write their cell phone numbers on the walls to say that this particular unit, this house was owned by this person, right? What is the challenge? Why the residents can't rebuild? So I'm thinking, number one, you'd actually need funding to rebuild your home. Magkano ba binibigay sa isang residente ng Marawi na may bahay doon? Sapat ba yun para makapagpatayo siya ng bahay? Kasi magpapatayo ka ulit, banyo, kusina, bibili ka ng furniture. So that's a lot of money per family.
Actually, Karen, meron tayong Victims Compensation Board, no? It's been created precisely to address that, no? Yung the need of the former residents of Marawi to be able to receive
But
support.
How much does one victim get?
Well, that would depend on the size of their house.
Give me an idea. Give me
well, I well, I don't have the figures right now, Karen, no? Kasi the board, the Marawi Compensation Board, is working on a very tight budget. Yun nga yung pinafight
ko
din
with us. Because yeah. You know how expensive it is to actually rebuild a house? I mean, there are homes there.
Materials.
They
need, no,
absolutely. They would need at least 2 million. At the very least, tipid na yun. I mean, is the Marawi Compensation Board giving a compensation literally for house building?
There are a mechanism, and the process that they do is they receive the petition. I mean, not petition, but application for a compensation package. You know, they started with the structures damage. You know, and they categorize that into household, business, etc. So para mas ano process. And as sabi ko nga, they've been working on a very tight budget. Remember in 2000, yeah. So the amount of money that you would receive would differ from the actual occupancy of the house that you had before the Marawi happened. And with all the losses, no, yung personal loss mo, if it's a business, of course you'll be receiving more. So it's not really the same. There's no ceiling or there's no actual minimum. But I agree, it has to be a minimum, no? Mayroong minimum. Pero as far as the amount concerns, differs from one person to another.
Okay, but that amount will not be enough for you to regain your life. That's the problem. So let's say you're given 100,000. Hypothetically, what will you do with 100,000? What you'll do, you'll save it. You'll use it for food. You'll use it for your kids' clothing expenses. But that will only take you what? Maybe I'll give it a few months. We're talking about 6 years now. Right? So clearly there are no mechanisms. Two, they're jobless. Because I've been there. I went to the relocation areas. They're jobless. So clearly you can't even get a bank loan because a bank will need a collateral. So ang tanong ko nga, is the model to rehabilitate Marawi, is this the right model? For example, would it have worked if the government gave a budget, let's say to Habitat for Humanity or to Gawad Kalinga? Because I've seen Marawi, the homes, dere-derecho yun eh. So technically, if you give the budget to Habitat or Gawad Kalinga, they'll rebuild it. Same size, same look, everything. You move back into that home. You can't get your old home back, but you'll get a new home. Same location. And then Habitat or Gawad Kalinga building it for you for a certain budget, let's say 2.5 million per home. So that's standard. Instead of giving the cash, you've actually within the 6 years built the homes.
Well, Karen, you know, Marawi have, you know, the place have various, you know, nuances. Though there's a dynamic going on in Marawi. A family's connection with the land is very, very precious to them. That's why the people there in Marawi City ought and to wait, no, for the compensation rather than receive, you know, a facility, no, be given by either the NGO or the government. Because
no, a home, a new home.
A new home.
A new
yes,
home in that same land.
Oh, in the same land.
In the same land.
In the same area.
Land. Yeah. In the same land.
Yeah. Well, the area where the 24 barangays, many we haven't actually, to be honest with you, we haven't thought about that. No, I personally haven't thought about that because we rely so much on the government's intervention. And it's a good thing that there are many several NGOs that may be willing to support in so far as the you know, homes are concerned or houses are concerned. But we also have to put into context, Karen, how important are the homes, because they didn't only lose properties. It's the memory. Some of the houses, in fact, are passed on. So,
yes, I agree with you, Representative, but how much would they need to go back and rebuild their homes?
Well, it would take so much. I agree with
That's
you.
The
there's
point.
no, there's no, There's no enough.
Ang tanong ko, when will they get to do it? Sige nga, it's been 6 years. If you go to a relocation center, kawawa sila doon. Where are they going to get 5 million? Where are they going to get 6 million? How?
Well, that's the reason why we have to give more, no? Enough funding for the Marawi Compensation Board in order to release the fundings that these families ought to receive. But sabi ko nga, Karen, you won't receive na nila yan.
But representative, aren't you asking for the ideal situation? The budget has been passed, right? The 5.7 trillion budget has been passed for 2024.
Yeah. So, what do you mean? The funding for the Marawi
absolutely.
Compensation?
Absolutely. So at the end of the day...
Yeah, I fought for that, Karen. In fact, the initial budget earmarked in 2023 was only 1 billion pesos. Imagine that. Because the budget came before the appointment of the board, meaning the activation of the compensation board. So DBM decided to earmark the minimum, according to the law, the minimum funding that you would apportion Marawi Compensation Board would be 1 billion pesos. So they settle all the minimum.
But for how many families? The 1 billion?
It would only cover, I think, families that I can count on with my fingers because ang dami nga dyan na mas malalaking bahay. Kaya nga, I fought for the increase. I even talked to Secretary Amina. We can't work on 2 billion and 1 billion pesos. You imagine you also have to finance the operation of the board and the administrative costs and etc. And then you minus that from the budget that would be distributed actual compensation package. So it would really create more chaos instead of addressing the concerns. So what I wanted sana is to work on 10 billion pesos each year. Kasi if that's 1 billion will go or 2 billion will be allotted to Marawi each year, it will take us more than a decade to finally finish everyone to receive all the compensation due to them. So I think it's better, sabi ko nga, it may be better to really finish the work if we provide more. I know that there's going to be no perfect or no satisfaction pag ako naka-receive. Like in my case, I'm a displaced person, Karen. That's why I had to move from Marawi City and settle someplace else temporarily because I...
All right. Okay. I think we lost.
Not to apply. Hindi kami nag-apply. We let the other residents to apply. So I agree with everything you said, Karen. We have to move outside, think outside of the box here. Because what we've seen for the past 6 years are intervention that do not perfectly address not only the rebuilding, the infrastructure, rebuilding of infrastructure, but the most important thing is the rebuilding of lives. So kailangan yung opportunity, kasi every time, sabi mo nga, you've been there in Marawi, you saw where they are staying right now, temporary shelters. Each day, that they lose opportunity. Each day. And yes. If you count all those days from the time that they moved out of Marawi, forcibly displaced, up to this day, each day, how much would that be if you quantify that in peso? Right? So I guess it's a matter of urgency now because we cannot just go back and address all this concern because we cannot really satisfy and really give the ideal amount that we need to provide for the families. But what we should maintain here is fairness. At least fair yung bibigay sa kanila and the services that they need. 6 years, it's not fair. It's simply not fair.
All right. Well, I want to thank you so much, Representative Zia Alonto Adiong, for your time today, sir. Mag-ingat po kayo.
Maraming salamat, Karen. Good morning.